I wanted to paint life. I wanted to express about my home, my family, flowers, things that I thought were beautiful in the world. I hope that people will be moved by looking at my art, because I have put myself right into it. This painting expresses things I loved about Chautauqua. The Picasso was representing the art part of it. The gladiolas were because every house at Chautauqua seemed to have gladiolas at the door, and that's about all the gardening that anybody did. I did that painting in my very first summer at Chautauqua, where I was able to go to classes 5 days a week for 3 hours. So I was able to have all that time to paint, and it was just marvelous. I felt I had come alive. I just was so happy. So I thought, this is what I will be. My husband Leon was an enormous support. Once he realized that I intended to make a career of being an artist, he was very helpful. Leon believed in daring in your own adventure, and he helped me to do that with my adventure. Having my own career as an artist has been very important in my family. I wanted my children to remember me for something other than my brisket. For 18 summers, I was the director of my own gallery in Chautauqua, New York. It is in an old barn, so it's rustic and it has a lot of visual excitement for people who came into the gallery. But once they were inside, I wanted to show really excellent art of the sort that I liked. And I had the challenge of running the business, and by having people coming and going and looking at the artwork, it actually stimulated my production of my own art. Chautauqua County is very, very beautiful. So not only did I have my home and the surrounding area around my house, which is very picturesque, but there is so much beauty all around. Monet is so closely associated with Giverny. Van Gogh is so closely associated with Arles. When I came to Chautauqua, I thought it was so beautiful. I wanted to paint it, and I wanted to be associated as a prominent artist of Chautauqua. It has given me a great deal of pleasure to be a gardener and be able to paint the flowers that I'm growing. So that's something that I look forward to every summer, and it has become more and more an important part of my art. I went to a lecture by Judy Chicago in Cleveland, and she said, if you think that you are going to be discovered in your studio and you are going to have a wonderful career, she said, wrong. You must go out and you must see what you would like to do, and then go for it. And Alan Alda told his daughter, if you want to be successful in the world, you have to have chutzpah. And I just love that, because I am naturally shy. It's really hard for me to go and ask to have a show. But because I was willing to go introduce myself to various institutions, within the last few years, I have shown at some very wonderful places. West Virginia University, the Roger Torrey Peterson Institute in Jamestown, New York, at the wonderful Michael Vern Gallery in Little Italy in Cleveland, and at the Cleveland Botanical Garden. This has been very exciting and very gratifying. In spite of all that does go on in the world that is harsh and painful, I think that it's a beautiful world. It deserves to be painted.